Great.
Start the recording and pull up the prelude. So this is where I share the screen. We got that on. And then
perfect.
Just a minute here. Welcome to our first Zoom, our first parish Zoom Vespers. I'm trying to find my script. I thought I had it up here. Just a minute. Oh dear, what could that be? Okay. It's coming, so just hang on a minute. It's very slow. You'd think that after these many Vesper services that I could do at least the first part without even looking. However, welcome to our virtual Vesper service. It's good to be with you all and share this time together. Our tech person this evening is Leslie Nelkin, and I'm Helen Lane. We gather every Thursday at 5:30 p.m. A reminder, our last Vespers for the year, for the church year, will be the last Thursday in May. You are all muted and will be throughout the service tonight. And we will be recording this session as usual, so that if you want to be off camera, please click your stop video. Should we encounter any technical issues, or if you can't hear or see something that you think you're supposed to, send us a message in the chat box. Let's offer each other grace and understanding through any problems that may arise. Even with the best laid plans, there are glitches. Have patience, and we hope that you can use any interruption as part of your contemplative practice of breathing and pausing. Make yourself comfortable, however that is for you. Be warm and relaxed. Adjust the light. Find a cushion or blanket. Get yourself ready to just settle in. Take a deep breath. Relax your body and set aside any concerns or feelings which may keep you from being present here and relaxing into the evening. So let's begin. Vespers is one of the traditional monastic daily prayers. Vespers is the evening prayer at sunset, a time for reflecting with gratitude on the day and unwinding into a more contemplative mindset. So let's listen to our centering music, Carlos Nakai Canyon Trilogy. So we have our chalice lighting. Today, we're going to light the chalice with these words by Robert Eller Isaac. This is a responsive reading, so perhaps you would like to repeat the response with me. Litany of Atonement, for remaining silent while a single voice would have made a difference. This is the response. We forgive ourselves and each other. We begin again in love. For each time that our fears have made us rigid and inaccessible, we forgive ourselves and each other. we begin again in love. For each time that we have struck out in anger without just cause, we forgive ourselves and each other. We begin again in love. For each time that our greed has blinded us to the needs of others, we forgive ourselves and each other. We begin in love. For those and for so many acts, both evident and subtle, which have fueled the illusion of separateness, we forgive ourselves and each other. We begin again in love. So take a moment now to think of your joys and sorrows and concerns for our world. We have a candle of joy. May our lives be filled with joy, both small and large. And next, a candle for our sorrows. May all our sorrows be brief. And finally, a candle for our concerns for the world. Good thing it wasn't real flannel. Let us pray for peace and for sustainability in our world. Now let's take a moment of silence with the ringing of our singing bowl. Tonight, we're going to focus on our theme for the month, which is atonement. Aaron Gandhi, grandson of Mohandas Gandhi, said, "Forgiveness without atonement is worthless, just as atonement without forgiving means very little." With poems, readings, and music, we will look at forgiveness and think about how it relates to atonement, to ourselves and to ourselves. Let's start with some quotes from Desmond Tutu. "Forgiving is not forgetting. It's actually remembering and not using your right to hit back. It's a second chance for a new beginning. And the remembering part is particularly important, especially if you don't want to repeat what's happened." Forgiving. And a second quote, "Forgiving and being reconciled to our enemies is our loved ones are not about pretending that things are other than they are. It's not about patting one another on the back and turning a blind eye to the wrong. True reconciliation exposes the awfulness, the abuse, the hurt, the truth. It could even sometimes make something worse. It is risky, a risky undertaking, but in the end, it's worthwhile because in the end, only an honest confrontation with reality can bring real healing. Superficial reconciliation can bring only superficial healing." And we have a song from Matthew West called "Forgiveness."
It's the hardest thing to give away, and the last thing on your mind today. It always goes to those who don't deserve. It's the opposite of how you feel when the pain they caused is just too real. Takes everything you have to say the word forgiveness. Forgiveness. It flies in the face of all your pride, moves away the mad inside. It's always anger's own worst enemy. Even when the jury and the judge say you got a right to hold a grudge, it's the whisper in your ear saying set it free. Forgiveness. Set a prisoner free. There is no end to what its power can do. So let it go and be amazed by what you see through eyes of grace. The prisoner that it really frees is you. Forgiveness.
So here is a poem by Mary Oliver. It's a bit of tongue-in-cheek, but I think speaks to what we're trying to think and talk about today. Angels are wonderful, but they are so, well, aloof. It's what I sense in the mud and the roots of the trees, or the well, or the barn, or the rock with its citron map of lichen that halts my feet and makes my eyes flare. Feeling the presence of some small god who abides there. If I were a perfect person, I would be bowing continuously. I'm not, though I pause wherever I feel this holiness, which is why I'm so often late for coming back from wherever I went. Forgive me. And Barbara Kingsolver has this to say. Listen, slide the weight from your shoulders and move forward. You are afraid you might forget, but you never will. You will forgive and remember. Think of a vine that curls from the small square plot that was once my heart. This is the only marker you need. Move on, walk forward into the light. For our contemplative practice this evening, we're going to again meditate on forgiveness and atonement in our lives. So if you'll get comfortable in your seat, take some deep breaths in and out. Allow the worries and concerns to flow out with your breath. Soften your gaze or close your eyes. Feel your whole body relax. Breathe deeply in and out and relax. Now think of a time, present or past, when someone did something hurtful to you. Or perhaps you did something that hurt and angered someone else. Let these memories flow through you as you listen to the babbling brook. Perhaps you are still angry, and the hurt, it still lives with you. How can you change it? First, forgive the other person or yourself. Try to understand why he did that, or how your action hurt the other. Really forgive them and yourself. And just let it go. Perhaps try for reconciliation by conversation with the other person. You have done all you can do. It's time to just let it go. Maybe make some changes in your life so there's no repetition. Try and feel that sense of freedom and relax, letting it all go for good. And now continue to meditate on that feeling as you listen to Anya let go. So let's come back to our space here together. Take some deep breaths. And our last poem is Mary Oliver's Wild Geese. You do not have to be good. You do not have to walk on your knees for 100 miles through the desert repenting. You only have to let the soft animal of your body love what it loves. Tell me about despair, yours, and I will tell you mine. Meanwhile, the world goes on. Meanwhile, the sun and the clear pebbles of the rain are moving across the landscape, over the prairies and the deep trees, the mountains and the rivers. Meanwhile, the wild geese, high in the clean blue air, are heading home again. Whoever you are, no matter how lonely, the world offers itself to your imagination, calls you like the wild geese, harsh and exciting, over and over, announcing your place in the family of things. And our last song is Writing a Better Story by Carrie Newcomer.
I'm writing a new ending with a better storyline. Turn the page and leave the blanks with a plot that's less defined. And though I won't get back a day of stolen time, I could go to bed at night with a better storyline. In the past, let the old house burn down and the wind scatter the ash. Forgive myself for all the broken glass, what I didn't know how to say or ask. I'm writing a new ending with a better storyline. Turn the page and leave the blanks with a plot that's less defined. Though I won't get back a day of stolen time, I could go to bed at night with a better storyline. When the breadcrumbs blew away and there was no way back, just the compass of my heart to find the path, seen only in the dark, flashed a lightning flash. I'm writing a new ending with a better storyline. Turn the page and leave the blanks with a plot that's less defined. Though I won't get back a day of stolen time, better storyline. There are stories shaped like stones, the ones our hearts have always known, the ones we finally call our own. Down where the spirit meets the bone, I'm ending where another story starts. At the edges I can grow, even when they're razor sharp. I'm grateful for the words that I bookmarked before I really knew I'd need them for this part. I'm writing a new ending with a better storyline. Turn the page and leave the blanks with a plot that's less defined. Though I won't get back a day's stolen time, I could go to bed at night with a better storyline.
So we come to the end of our Vespers service. We thank you for sharing this time with us. We hope that you will join us every Thursday evening to relax, to take it all in, to move into a quiet, contemplative evening. Our closing music is Luli Lula Lulai, arranged by Philip Stopford. I want to send you off hoping that you can let go of the past, any past or present hurts or anger. Find the freedom of letting go as you settle into this beautiful, gentle lullaby. You may leave as you wish, and we will wave our goodbyes in silence at the end of the music. My closing words are from John O'Donohue. May there be a kindness in your gaze when you look within. May you allow the wild beauty of the invisible world to gather you, to mind you, and embrace you in belonging. Thank you, Leslie.
Did it go okay? I couldn't see the visuals.
Oh, it was perfect. You did a very good job. Yes, oh. I was the one that messed up all over the place. Oh, well.
Maybe I'm getting better at it. You didn't mess up.
Oh, well, yeah, I couldn't find my script. And
yeah, but.
I don't know where it went. Well, I think sometimes I have a magic mouse, and sometimes I'll hit it without knowing and things will disappear. So anyway, thank you so much. You did
You're
a beautiful
welcome.
Job.
It was a beautiful service.
Well, I love that lullaby. I could just listen
beautiful.
To that. Oh, yeah, I had a lot of fun doing it. I left out all of the Dalai Lama. I just